first and foremost part of the of our being here is to understand the accounting. In my first inaugural address, I was just discussing it's the easiest thing to understand, easiest thing to implement, and easiest thing to take during your course of whatever services, whatever working you are doing. We all people are, I think, in the accounting department. All are in accounting department. Okay. Even if the person, I was objecting Dr. Professor Patak's lecture here, but he just went away. I'll give him writing that even if you teach any technical or any subject, they must keep one subject of accounting in all sciences. One basic conceptual subject of accounting they must have always. Otherwise, what will happen? They will misunderstand. Like Ms. Professor Patak telling to madam, ki madam is harassing, some document is not there, some voucher is not there, etc., etc. So one subject, particularly in the first year or second, they must have of accounting, so that they can understand the conceptual issues of the accounting. Okay. Now we come to the accounting. Accounting is made of what? Accounting is made for what? For a unit, for a institution, for a trade, for a commerce, for industry, or for anything. The concept is different, it will come later, but I'll tell you one very important thing is accounting, the person who is doing the accounting, the person who is owner of the entity, the person who is behaving with the accounting are completely different than the entity for which we are making the account. It is not a fundamental accounting principle, it is accounting concept. But whenever I go and discuss, I will discuss only first, because we are taking the lectures for the bureaucrats, IAS officers, then Rajasthan or other state accounts officers, because they are coming from the RAC exam, different examination. They are not coming from the chartered accountants examination. So the first and foremost thing you to understand that will make everything easier to you is that the person who is preparing the account, the person who is owner of the institution, the person director of the institution, the person employee of the institution or anything is completely different than the entity for which you are making, you are preparing the account. Is very clear? Very clear. Now what entity is what? Entity is an artificial person. Nothing. And he, that artificial person, that say this is the entity. I can say this mobile is an entity. Mobile can understand a lot of things. I can say this pen is an entity. Okay. Now this entity does not understand anything. Does not understand anything. It understands only that who is transacting to me. Who is in contact with me, who is working with me, and under what circumstances and under what nature it is working. And it asks every question to you only. Like you gave this entity 500 rupees. This entity says 500 given, so I will not keep. They say I don't. I am only a small entity, so I will not keep anything with me. So this 500 rupees where to put? I have given, I am owner of this entity, I have given 500 rupees, okay, I am giving 500 rupees just to start. Say, no, I don't need any money. So I have given 500 rupees to entity, it says from where to put. The money has to go where? I don't keep any pocket, I don't keep anything. I am a single artificial person, simple, nothing. So it says, okay, you give me 500 rupees, I tell him that you... time being put in the cash box. So it is okay. I put in the cash box. So it is a box. Okay. So it says, box, I am giving you 500 rupees. I will take back from you. So it will debit. Hindi mein bolte naam likh dena. Debit cash box. That I have given you 500 rupees, I will take from back. take back from you. So it will debit to cash box, cash account debit, cash box debit, 500 rupees. Then the system is, it says that I keep the account equal. The balance should be zero, debit credit should be zero. So I'll credit to whom? Kiske jama karun, kiska jama karun? Bola Shyam Agarwal. Who are you? Say I am owner. Okay, you are owner. What owner means in the account? I say it is capital. Okay, capital. So I credit capital Shyam Lal Agarwal. Finish. So it is a computer box. Whatever I put inside, it covers. Okay. So it is a double entry accounting system. This entity says, I have given you 500 rupees, cash box, debit. Who have given me? I am a partner, proprietor, owner. Who are you? I am Shyam Agarwal. Okay, Shyam Agarwal. For what you are giving? I am giving as a capital. Okay, capital. Capital account credit. Account tallied. Tallied? Very clear. So now you come out any transaction in your life, in institution, you think all those transactions in such a manner, you will find the solution. One solution is very clear, that whatever amount has come, whatever amount has gone, whatever asset has come, whatever asset has gone, whatever expenditure I have incurred, whatever revenue I earned, there are two entries. One is debit, one is credit. This should be clear in your mind. And both debit and credit. Debit means I have to take money from you, and if I take money from you, I'll give to somebody. So balance is clear. So this concept you should keep in mind all the way. This is the main concept of the accounting. Never think that this is owner. This pen, this entity is not owner anything. It is only an entity which is keeping an account for you. So it is not coming in picture. It neither carry asset nor carry liability, nothing. Whatever you put, debit and credit. Now what is debit and what is credit? What is debit and what is credit? Debit means, suppose I have given 500 to him. So I'll ask 500 to him. So I am a, even if capital, I am giving as a capital, but I have given 500 to entity. I see entity, I have given you 500 loan or capital, whatever, I can take back from you. So this says, I have to pay Mr. Agarwal 500 back. Now I am owner, or I am a creditor, I am giving money to him as a capital, or as a loan, or as a supply of material. In any case, this entity has to give me back money. Okay? Now it depends on the transaction, what transaction you are carrying out. And that is why professor was right to tell to madam, that madam wants the transaction supporting evidence. Okay? Because if you go to the evidence can convert an asset into an expenditure. Evidence can convert a liability into income, because both are credit. Suppose I am giving 1,000 rupees to this entity. This entity can say 1,000 rupees is fees given by Mr. Shyam Agarwal to me. So if it is a fees to the entity, it is income of this entity. If say I am giving a loan to this entity, then it is a liability. So mind it that loan or income are on one side. Income and liability is on one side. And suppose this entity gives you 2,000 rupees. So if gives you 2,000 for giving a lecture, it becomes expenditure. Kharcha ho gaya. It will not come back. And if you give 2,000 as advance, then it will come back. So it has become expenditure or asset. If the money has to come back to this entity again, then it is a asset. If it is not coming back, it is expenditure. If it has to pay somebody back, it is a liability. And if it need not to pay back, it becomes its income. So this is a basic principle of accounting which everybody must understand. It appears to be very simple, but it's very logical. logical in the sense that it goes by its own basic principle, and very simple, and you know, very conceptual and very easy to understand. Now you tell me, anybody sitting here could understand this transaction or not? Anybody is aware of not? Now is fully aware that asset and expenditure are one side and liability and income are other side. Because liability and income are credit and asset and income is debit. So this is the principle of basic principle of accounting, that this entity does not carry anything. Either it has to pay or it has to recover. It has to incur or it has to create an asset. Either it is income or it is a liability. So these basic principles of accounting takes you a long way. Now you, every transaction, any transaction in your life comes, you should think only four corners in your mind. Only four corners. Any transaction will either be a income or a liability, and counterpart will be asset or expenditure. Okay? Or it can be increasing a liability. A liability may increase and other liability may decrease. Or asset may increase or other asset may decrease. So it will counter the transaction. This is the basic principle. Asset and liability are the balance sheet, because asset and liability word says that those asset and liability, what is asset word liability? Whatever transaction is carried on in any entity, if the transaction, after incurring the transaction, it is not to be discussed in future, not to be recovered in future, not to be paid in future, nothing to be done, you know, it becomes gone case. Kharcha ho gaya, khatam. Income ho gayi, khatam. If that is the matter, then it is either income or expenditure, finish. But if whatever transaction has taken place in the next year, because accounts are paid on a particular date, or next period, it may be 1 month, 2 months, if those transactions carry in the next period also, if they are carried either as asset or a liability, then it comes in the balance sheet. So the expenditure income means they are not carried for the next period, or income or expenditure. If they are carried, it becomes asset or liability. So we concluded that there is a profit and loss account, income and expenditure account, and there is a balance sheet. All others are part of all these two things. So whenever you carry any transaction, you think in your mind that where it will go. Suppose I purchase this furniture. So this entity say, furniture purchase, I don't know furniture. What is furniture? Furniture. Okay, furniture account debit. I'll recover from the furniture. Why you recover from the furniture? Why? Because furniture is not an expenditure. Furniture is not a expenditure. Furniture will provide you facility to speak, to sit for 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 10 day, 1 year, 2 year, 3, whatever it may be the life. But it will provide you the facility to work. Okay? So it becomes asset. So I say furniture is asset. So it is furniture debit. Now who has given the furniture? A supplier. X and company. It means I have to pay X and company some money. So furniture debit, X and company credit. I have to pay money to X and company, we recover from the furniture. Now why I have taken this example? You cannot recover the furniture, it is not a cash box. So what will the recovery? When 1 year complete or 1 period complete, I say furniture of 1000 rupees has become now 800 rupees. Because its life is only 5 years. Or 4 years, whatever it is. So 250 rupees expenditure. So what I will say, whatever income is there, I will charge from the income, telling that I have purchased a furniture. Of that furniture, some part is lost, it depreciated. So that money I have to recover from the income. So that becomes the depreciation. So that 200 recover from the furniture and you pay to the creditor. If you pay him early, then you are paying from the other income, other balances, other credit. From where? Suppose you want to pay X and company 2000 rupees. From where you pay? Because furniture depreciation may take 4 years. X and company not remain pending 4 years. So I, as a owner, give you 2000 rupees capital. So liability of capital increases. I will pay 2000 rupees, my account 2000 credit more. So that will increase. And the liability to X and company will decrease. So increase in liability and decrease in liability is the similar transaction. Increase in asset, decrease in asset is a similar transaction. Increase in expenditure or decrease in expenditure can also be the same. One expenditure can be recovered, one can be paid. Increase in income, decrease in income can also be the same. But the trial balance, the balance of debit and credit should tally. So every transaction, wherever it comes in your life, you imagine that is a system of simple debit and credit, nothing else. And while carrying out the transaction, while carrying out the evidence, checking everything, you should find whether this transaction is creating asset or it is expenditure. Will not create asset. Whether it is coming to me as income, need not to pay back, or I have to pay back the money it has come. Those two principles only you have to account for while discussing every transaction. And this discussion will take you a long way. And you will simply able to prepare everything. Cash basis accounting, double entry system accounting, accrual accounting, there are three accounting systems. People are confused. The cash basis accounting is double entry accounting. Or double entry account is cash basis accounting. Accrual accounting is different accounting. But what is cash basis accounting? Previously, what was happening in the government sector, you are given the budget. Okay? Budget means treasury payment. Now, what you normally used to do it, that whatever payment you want to make, salary or establishment or PF or some expenditure or consultancy, etc., etc., these are the recurring charges. Okay? So you had a budget of recurring expenditure. Okay? Non-recurring expenditure or capital budget or revenue budget, whatever it can be called. So capital budget, you say furniture, fixture, or fan or some AC or some, you know, some equipment, etc. So that is capital budget. So budget is given to you. Whenever somebody supplies you material, you approve it. Okay, put that budget 5000, less incurred 200, balance 4800. Okay, mark the budget register and bill is passed, sealed, signed, verified and sent to the treasury. Treasury pays it. So that is a cash basis accounting, single entry system. Because you don't make double entry. Who will pay? Treasury will pay. What you have a budget. Whatever income comes to you, whatever scrap sale or any miscellaneous deposit or any earnest money deposit or anything which may come to you or any fees, etc., whatever you recover, that is your income. So what you say? Amount received as fees, credit to the treasury. Under head 2416, 342, 342, whatever. There are two heads. One is loan head, another is the receipt head. So receipt head, you credit to the treasury and the things are gone. So you need not to maintain any account. That is the single entry system. Normally people say cash basis of accounting. But cash basis accounting is basically a double entry system accounting. Whenever you make two entries of one transaction, it becomes double entry accounting. When you don't make any entry, then it becomes single entry. Single entry, double entry, both can be cash basis. But double entry can be accrual basis also. What is accrual, what is cash basis, that I'll explain further later. But you first understand there are three system accounting, not two. People always confuse. Whenever I go to take a lecture, even professional people, certain professional people are taking lecture, they say that the accounting is the two only. One is cash system, one is accrual system. Now, in person working in the government department, they, for them it is very, necessary to understand there are three accounting systems, not two. So whatever in education system we are following, if a department is there, then you are following single entry system. Because department says, whatever budget comes to you, verify the bill, paid, sent into department, budget head, and it's cleared. So for department, it is a single entry. But for the institution as a whole, it is a double entry on cash basis. Double entry on cash, because in institution, some grant comes. So they have to take grant income and debit to the bank account. So bank account debit and grant account credit. They have to make one entry. They have to maintain a cash book at the center level. So what is cash book? Cash book is not a single entry. Cash book is a double entry. Why double entry? Because one part of the entry is already in the cash book. Suppose you pay the amount as expenditure. So you go, what entry will make? Expenditure account debit to cash. Okay, cash gone to you. So two cash box se aapne cash le liya. Whenever you take back from cash box you have to credit because you have taken money from cash box. You are given, debited, taking, credit him. So that give him credit. So credit cash box, debit to expenditure. Because to whom you are paying? I am paying for the establishment. So this entity says, okay, establishment debit. Now whether recoverable or not recoverable, that you decide. No, say I say establishment, salary, PF, gratuity, printing stationery, telephone, they are revenue head. So it say, okay, establishment, bracket by revenue head, debit. Understanding debit, okay? So it will go to revenue expenditure. So this is the system. When cash book is maintained, it is a double entry. It's not a single entry. When cash book is not maintained, only budgetary system is done, it becomes a single entry. So you should be clear what is single entry, what is double entry. But what happens in the government department, education department, you prepare the cash book, then you see it is single entry. Whatever amount you pay, you just list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, make it total and then cash balance itna. How much amount cash balance and make total, give it the money. Finish. Single entry. Because you are not preparing the, you are not posting the entries made in the cash book, head wise. You are not making the classification. What you are doing? You are having the classification register. Some people have classification in the cash book only. 1, 2, 3 columns, etc. They will total the cash book, they will classification cash book. It is a double entry. Because once you are telling that cash came from whom? Bank. So you say total payment made by each department, say one department paid 10 lakh rupees on various heads, and the closing balance is 10,000 rupees, the bank. So 10 lakh, 10,000 is total. Okay, 10 lakh come from where? Either it has come from the head office, so it will say HO. Central office, it will say CO. Registrar office, it will say registrar office. Or from bank, it will say bank credit. Because sometimes money may be given to bank extra. Or sometimes the previous balance of bank may be utilized this year. So the opening balance of bank was 10 lakh. And now closing balance is 10,000. So bank has, opening balance of bank has provided you funds to incur the expenditure. So this is the system. So whenever a cash book is prepared, you should prepare a trial balance, known as trial balance, that from where the money came and where money goes. And what was the opening balance in our pocket? What was the closing balance? A simple system. You go from the house, whatever money available in the pocket is your asset. Asset means it was opening balance on the day when you started your journey. It is your asset on the first day. Now, whatever money came inside, suppose somebody gave you 200 rupees fees for lecture. So that is lecture fees. 100 rupees pocket, 200 lecture fees, 300 income. Expenditure. Miscellaneous expenditure 250 rupees, balance 50 with cash, so it is a cash balance. So opening balance 100 rupees, 200 rupees income, 250 rupees expenditure, and 50 with cash balance, trial balance tally, 300, finish. So take your pocket as a trial balance. You will understand every transaction. Now in the pocket and the entity, only one difference is certain expenditure are revenue expenditure, certain expenditure are capital expenditure. Revenue expenditure paid, finish. capital expenditure you incurred, but the benefit will be available on next period also. I gave you salary. Salary month finish. Next month it will not be available to you. Next month you again want a salary. So, gone, finish. But I gave you the advance. Food grant advance. So, say food grant advance. 10,000 will be given. Every month 1,000 reduction. So, gave in September 6 month reduction. 4,000 will be deducted next year. So, 4,000 is advance. Not deducted. That I'll take next year. You assume that everything is paid. First you understand everything is paid. Because if you don't understand everything is clear, then we'll not be able to understand next step. So first we should understand everything is paid. Paid, incurred. Or not incurred, credited or debited. If not incurred, debited or credited. I told you now, when I supply a furniture, it is either paid from the cash box, not paid, it is credited. It means it is credited to my head. So 1,000 rupees I am giving a lecture, I am not getting a fees. It is debited to institution. IIT Bombay, 1,000 is recoverable. So, but I can expend only in my pocket balance. So cash balance will go by the cash book. So cash, so far cash book is concerned, it is concerned only with the cash. So far paid or not paid is concerned, it is not concerned with the cash book. This transaction will not be entered in cash book. Cash has to tally. Pocket cash, morning, evening has to tally in the evening. No transaction which not paid or not received will not come in the cash book. So that will be a separate book. That will be a separate book, or people for convenience keep a different column in cash book. So that is debit and credit side. That is a contra entry. Debit also, credit also. So for that there is a separate book called as journal. Journal says two entries. Because one entry in cash book, what is benefit? You have to make only one entry, it becomes double entry. Because once you pay expenditure and put on credit side of the cash, the opening balance 100 rupees get reduced by payment. So closing will be 50 only. So one entry to credit the cash is not required to make. Because cash balance is written in the left side, right side you make the expenditure entry. So balance is 50 rupees cash. Automatic cash reduced. Automatic cash reduced. So because cash book is maintained on opening balance, closing balance, so second entry is not required to make, because one side is already there in the cash book. That is the simple system. You put any example in your life and calculate, you will find it is very easy. You make entry first separately and then maintain the cash book, you find the same balance. And you will say it is very easy. So this is the cash basis accounting you must first understand. Is clear everybody? No problem? So how easy it? It is the easiest thing in the life, because normally since morning to evening we are maintaining a cash book. At every point we are, whenever you go to a shop, you will find how much money I have for. No, I don't have for. Kahan gaya bhai? Where for the? Okay, opening wise 5,000. I drawn back again 5,000, became 10,000. But I paid 10,000 the school fees. So money is not here. 10,000 is 10,000, so it's gone, balance left. So purchasing cannot be done. Every moment you prepare the cash balance, cash book in your pocket. So this is the cash book and cash system of accounting. And it is a double entry. When you prepare cash book, it is a double entry system of accounting. Okay? Now double entry and accrual system of accounting, what is the difference? Why MHRD is behind everybody to prepare account on double entry accounting system? This concept I wanted to take later, but I'll give you just brief only, because first we have to go to accounting concept. All accounting concept, there are a lot of accounting given in the book. So I'll go by, you know, item wise, so that whenever you read, you find this is what that, okay? So double entry accounting, why ministry is interested is that at any cutoff date, any point of time, you are not able to understand and arrive at and report that what is my asset today and what are my liabilities as on today. Because you are accounting only payment basis. Whatever paid, you treat expenditure. What are recovered, you treat as income. So you are not able to understand at a particular date, which is normally end of the year, end of the month, end of the quarter, you are not able to understand that how much asset I have, how much amount I have to recover, and how much amount I have to pay. That is my liability. Even if I have not received any amount, I have to recover. Even if I have not paid the amount, I have to pay. So some people carry, I am in good position, having a lot of cash balance, but at next morning, on 1st April, 1st April, he has to pay immediately all the payment. So his enjoyment goes, you know, only for 2, 3, 4, 5 days. When the days come, balance becomes nil. So that is why ministry came, that there should be an accrual system of accounting. In accrual system of accounting, only one thing comes, that on a particular date, you are aware that what is my asset and what is my liability. Whether amount received to you or not, if it was income, you will account for as income and saying that I have to recover this income from these fellows. List it out. And whatever is your expenditure, whether you incurred the expenditure, you have to pay the salary all the people, but salary bill is not paid in March, you have to pay in April. So you must know how much amount I have to pay on account of salary for the particular year in which the persons have done the job. So why particular year? To have a matching concept that whatever income you account for is your particular period, particular year, and expenditure also for a particular year, so that they can match together. If it don't match, then mismatch will be there. In one year, income will be huge. In another year, expenditure will be huge. So a matching concept is coming when you have accrual system of accounting. So when you start accrual system of accounting, you will learn matching concept, maturity concept, going concern, a lot of concept will come. Those concepts, you will automatically understand when you start making the transaction. Automatically understand. So first I'll take up the concept, terminology, and then we'll conclude the mercantile system of accounting or the accrual system of accounting or the people say double entry system of accounting, double entry case also, but normally double entry people say it is accrual based accounting. So not to be confused now. So all these terms, I think you will be very clear for that. So let us go item to item, what are the accounting names? What are the accounting heads? We'll go by A, B, C, D, okay? So that you can understand well. Account. One you will find account. Kya bolenge? You will say account. What account? Furniture account, Ram Lal account, Shyam Lal account, salary account, PF account, okay? Expenditure, whatever name you have in your mind, you know, institution, fees account, caution money deposit, account. Every head of receipt or payment, every head of income or expenditure, every head of asset or liability, whatever may be head, which is not matching in one head. Salary means salary payment. Now salary payment, you want subhead? Salary payment to admin staff, salary payment to technical staff, salary payment to higher staff, salary payment to junior staff, salary payment to peons, salary payment to drivers. You can have separate heads also. So how many heads, what number of heads are there? You can have more heads, you can have less heads. There can be one main group, that salary payment. Okay, salary payment. Now in salary payment, you can have salary ministerial staff, salary education staff, salary other staff, whatever names you want. You can have subheads. So account means there will be an account of that particular type of transaction. So that the particular type of transaction you can get at one place. Because whatever entry you are having in cash book, cash payment, and whatever entry you are having when we see the mercantile ledger and journal book, both are posted to a account ledger. So posting is made account wise. Suppose you have to make payment salary every month. So this account will say, it will have the, you know, date, particular and amount, okay? So it will say date on 4th April 2013, amount
salary paid cash, cash accrual based, you will say salary payable, you will say amount. So those entries which are related to salary for the whole year or the whole period, suppose you want to make total quarterly, you can make quarterly account. Yearly is yearly account. Normally we take yearly so that you can understand better. But instead of yearly, you can make quarterly or monthly or half yearly also. Okay. So yearly account means a particular account of which all transactions, whether debit or credit, are entered in that particular account. So we prepared a trial balance while making the cash book. I'll tell you only two entries. Okay. Value two entries. One entry, I have given 1000 rupees cash as a capital. So this entity will say 1000 rupees credit to Shyam Agarwal capital account. Capital account bracket means Shyam Agarwal, because some there may be partnership from then there will be two persons. So it will be capital account Shyam Agarwal. A proprietor, proprietor capital account. A partner, capital account Shyam Agarwal. Okay. Debit to cash box debit. So, cash account debit to Shyam Agarwal. Okay. Now second entry. I have paid cash to purchase furniture. Okay. So furniture account debit 1000 to cash, cash se apne wapas le liya. So furniture debit to cash 1000. So 1000 box mein tha, 1000 wapas chala gaya. So cash balance become nil. Now what happened? 1000 furniture is asset debit and 1000 capital is credit. So trial balance is 1000 asset, furniture account debit, and Shyam Lal Agarwal trial balance tally. This is tally. In this fashion, whatever transaction you want, this debit and credit will tell you. Now says, in furniture account there are five entries. In first month I purchased 1000, in second month I purchased 2000, in third month I purchased 4000, in fifth month I purchased 10,000. So how do you know total furniture account? You cannot know. So what happened in cash book? I paid all the time cash, all the time cash payment to the company, you know, this entity. 1000 gave, 1000 cash box, 2000 gave, 2000 cash box, 5000, 5000 cash box. Now 1000 cash box become paid to furniture, nil. 2000 given to paid furniture, nil. 5000, 5000 paid nil. So total amount 8000 furniture and 8000 capital. So from where will get 8000? Will not get 8000 one place. Because not only furniture entry, there are other entries also in the cash book. So all the entries in the cash book will be posted to the respective account. Okay? And that account will tell you in the whole year, 8000 is entry, 8000 cash came, balance nil. Now there will be 1000 entries. So that way 1000 entries amount will have definitely has to be in cash book. And there will be 10 heads. So all 10 heads taking together will tally to the total amount available as credit to the cash book. Very easy. So like two entries, there can be five, then you add six, then seven, then eight, then nine, then 10. Then prepare the trial balance. Then there can be 10,000. So it doesn't make a difference. The difference will come only when in the cash book side, I have written 5,000 as furniture purchase. While posting to furniture account, you write 6,000 wrongly. So if I purchase 5,000, you have to debit furniture only 5,000, not 6,000. That you have to mind. If you debit 6,000, then your balance will not tally, because 1,000 where will it come? In cash book, 5,000 only I paid, 5,000 paid to furniture. So you will have a difference. So that will give difference. So our ledger account is prepared to have all type of transaction of a particular head at one place. So that for the complete year, you can know how much expenditure I incurred on salary. Say 2 lakh rupees. Who paid? 2 lakh rupees Shyam Lal Agarwal paid. Shyam Lal Agarwal is who? I am a proprietor. You are proprietor. So you paid as loan or capital? 1 lakh I paid as capital, 1 lakh as loan. Why you paid loan? Why you paid capital? Because I paid capital for 1 lakh. Because I had only 1 lakh in my head. Another 1 lakh is not I am having. So fair money will come in the next year. With this salary, I will earn money. So from that earning, I will take 1 lakh back. So next year what happened? You arrange the classes, all those faculty, you earned 4 lakh from the classes, and 2 lakh is expended the salary, so 2 lakh gone, 2 lakh you saved. Out of 2 lakh, 2 lakh is available in cash box. So out of cash box, loan is paid. What will happen? My loan is paid. Capital normally is not paid. So 1 lakh my loan is paid, 1 lakh become nil, and cash balance of 2 lakh becomes 1 lakh. So that account is tally. So this says who has given you the money. Now the question, double entry will come. Okay, the money was not there, then whom you have to pay? I have purchased furniture, 10,000. I have to pay X and company. So trial balance will say furniture, 10,000, and payable to X and company, 10,000. Balance, tally. So at each and every entry, the balance of debit and credit means asset and liability, expenditure or income should tally. In all the debit heads, there are either expenditure or asset. In all the credit head, there is a liability or income. So both credit and their nature is credit. Because whenever amount comes to you as a profit, even if it is a profit, why it is credit? Now concept of credit is from where it comes. Suppose this is a business entity. You have given him 2,000 income, no expenditure, nothing. No, not only one. It has received 2,000 rupees as cash. Why? Because I am owner of this entity. I came here to take a lecture. And professor paid cash 2,000 rupees in the name of this entity. This Shyam Agarwal and company. My firm name is Shyam Agarwal and company. So he made a check or cash. Shyam Agarwal 2,000 rupees. So it got 2,000 rupees. And it is, no, it's not income, it's not mine. Because I have to keep nothing. So who is the owner? Shyam Agarwal. So I have to pay to Shyam Agarwal. So kya karega? 2,000 income will come in income side, no transaction. Then in the P&L account, it will say transfer to capital account. Means income, who is the owner of the income? Me. So it will transfer to my account. Then income will come credit to my account. So whenever cash will be there, it will be paid to me. So that is why the entity concept comes. Income does not pertain to this. Income does not pertain to this. So whatever income is there, the income is also liability for the entity. Because income does not belong to this entity. You got this point? Now I think it should be very clear. Even income comes to, people may say, income is your asset. People are confused. Whatever income or entity, it is his asset. It is income. He should be powerful. He should have asset. It's true. But income is not his income. Income relates to either proprietor or partner. So net income less expenditure, balance income, it will credit to owner. So it will keep balance. Okay. Now what is net balance? 2,000. So 2,000 income he has to pay to me. Where is 2,000? 1,000 cash box, 1,000 recoverable from IIT. So when IIT people give him, it will give 1,000 to me. If I want to cash 1,000, I can take 1,000 cash. So account is nil. So income does not relate to entity. That is why income is also a liability. You got the point? You have to put this finally in your mind. Income is not asset of this company. Income is a liability. Whenever I go to government department, they say, "Are, what you are doing, Mr. Agarwal? I have won 50 crore rupees profit and you are showing in liability side. Hey, how it is liability? It is my profit." Because whatever P&L account, net profit comes, it transferred to the liability side. Because liability side, we have capital. Because capital for this company, whatever capital I am giving, it is liability for it. This entity, I am giving a capital. But the capital is also liability for this fellow. I am prepare account for this, not me. Not my individual inside, my heart. My heart debit credit are different for this. So I am giving capital, it is liability for it. So I said, sir, whatever profit you are earning, that is also liability for the company, because this company has to pay to government. No. It is my company. I am the government officer and I am managing director. This should be my asset. You are not mistaking and you don't understand. you should be removed from the auditor. Well, ultimately, this is happening in the bureaucracy. So this is very must, Bakshi sir, that you must have the classes first for the bureaucrats, second for the accounts officer, so that they can understand what is this. Because what happened, once we go to the seat, na, we say, normally I discuss, sir, in cash-based accounting also, we have to prepare balance sheet. Balance sheet? What balance sheet? There is no accrual, no money came, money gone, only cash balance. There, why? Because, sir, as on the closing day, whatever is a cash balance, that is asset of that company, and that asset has to be paid to the owner. So owner is the liability. No, you were mistaken. I am the managing director. That is a big problem. I am the secretary MHRD. How, Bakshi, you understand like this? So that becomes the problem. So whenever I take classes for bureaucrats, because normally I teach in the OTS of State Bank also, I first teach them the first lesson that this entity is different and you are different. That is the first part. So this will make you understand a lot of things. Now you will think any transition will be very easy for you to understand. So this entity concept is a must for you, and that is the part that we are working in this environment. That the easiest thing, you ask, whenever I read accounting, in 10th class and 11th class, I had accounting system. Because my father is shopkeeper, okay? So in, I think when I ended in 8th or 7th class, I used to write the books of the shop. This, that line. So I used to, whenever I used to go in the school and classes, I used to speak. Sir, aise hoga. This will happen like this. Well, how do you know? I am doing in my routine practice. So that makes you very easy to understand. And if any person in the country does not understand accounting, even if becomes IIT in top or any topper, I think he is failing in his duty, because always he will be questioning those things which will completely be rational, unethical. And in any center, even if it is a medical, it is a IIT, it is a engineering, it is a technical, civil, or whatever wing, they are especially only for one thing, their particular subject. And you're an accountant, you are especially for every sector, because whatever you medical profession, you want to purchase medical equipment, how much money you have paid? 10,000. Why 10,000? In market available 6,000, madam says, no, you first year bought 6,000, now how pay 10,000? Oh, madam, my janne, it was non-people. Or why non-people? You have got tendering system, open system, how you going to do it? How, what is the life of it? 3 year. 3 year life only, where is the manufacturing schedule? What is the system? So accountants are much more powerful, they understand everything. Not one subject, there is no one science. Accountant is the science of every sciences that convert into all the transaction into a monetary system, and by which everything is measured, monitored, controlled and administered. So this is the most important accounting system. Thank you very much.